the plan for the destruction of the United States of America and the formation of a socialist, totalitarian, one-world government under the United Nations is contained within a set of top-secret documents with the title Majesty 12, spelled M-A-J-E-S-T-Y-T-W-E-L-V-E. The philosophy of the Mystery School is the Luciferian philosophy, as put forth by General, that's Christopher Albert Pike, where understanding, or the ability to keep the secrets, stops, the progress of the candidate stops, and they never ever progress any higher. Only those above the 29th degree have the ability to understand the ultimate secrets and goals of the order. A very promising select few are handpicked for progress beyond the 32nd degree. Those chosen disappear behind the veil and become one of the, quote, thousand points of light, end quote, but they are more properly known as the Magi. That process has always been the protection of the Illuminati in a Christian world that has had a tendency to burn at the stake those who differed in belief or philosophy, has resulted in the Brotherhood's hatred of Christianity and the goal of the ultimate extermination of all religions save theirs. Before you begin blabbering that Albert Pike's name never included Christopher, you better look up the meaning of that name and further understand that the Christ of the Mysteries has absolutely nothing to do with the Christ of the New Testament, at least not in the manner in which it is interpreted by the Christian Church. Christopher literally means Christ-like. It is a metaphor for the development of the thinking man through the process of evolution and the eventual domination of the universe by learning how to dominate and control nature. This process is called magic. The result will be the apotheosis of the race of mankind and the elimination of all who cannot make this paradigm shift in the coming new age. The alchemists had the same religion, but disguised it under the profane interpretation of the exoteric or outward expression of turning lead into gold. The search for the philosopher's pure red stone was really the attempt to perfect the soul of mankind. Now listen to me carefully. The goal is the ultimate extermination of all religions except for their religion. And yes, there is a religion. Those who are attracted to the mysteries who are unable to grasp the esoteric meaning of their education often take the exoteric meaning to be the truth and turn to Satan or Lucifer as their object of worship, never understanding the metaphor for a much deeper philosophy. The Order never objects to this because these Satan worshippers are useful in their own manner. They furnish a diversion and are often a source of large sums of money, although the Brotherhood, folks, has seldom found themselves lacking in fools or funds. Fire is the god of the mysteries, and its priests are the philosophers of fire. They believe that any concept of creation must result in the idea that all things are manifestations of the Creator, which is pantheism, since man is the only creation with intelligence and original thought. The combined or collective consciousness of mankind, they believe, is the mind of God, ergo, man is God. That should enlighten you to the source of some of the more difficult to understand concepts of the so-called New Age movement. Don't get the fool called by the mysteries, the profane, mixed up with the king or the initiate known as Fraternius Rex Mundi. Those who cannot understand this philosophy through the hidden language of symbology and make the shift in thinking for the coming millennium are doomed to extinction. Wake up, you've been had. And wise up, none of you are even remotely as smart as you think you are.
I'm sorry, I gotta see the hands. I'm not one of them.